Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com. In today's video, I really want to answer a question. How to download images in SwiftUI with MVVM? Let's learn the MVVM pattern in SwiftUI by building out this project. Hit that subscribe button, open up Xcode, and let's dive in. So let's just jump right into the demo project and see what we are going to build out today. Well, first of all, we have this empty list and a pulsating fetch button at the bottom. So let's push that button. There we go. It's fetching our users and it is also populating the images from a URL. So hey, surprise, we are going to learn how to also fetch URL images inside SwiftUI in this tutorial. So that is what we are going to build out today. So let's just jump right into it. If you want to take a look at the code, go ahead and click the link down below in the description. So I have already created this starter project and it is called SwiftUI MVVM, entitled very cleverly. And what is basically MVVM? Well, it is a kind of a helper for MVC, meaning that when you code in MVC, your view controller will get very ugly very soon they call it the massive view controller, funnily. And for that, there is this MVVM concept of separating your view code from your logic. And it's called MVVM because it's model view view model. Now the model is your model of your object, the views are your views, of course, and the view model is basically the link between those, and it's called the view model. So let's see what we have here. For now, we have a content view with our dummy users. We'll get back to that in just a moment. In the view, we have a VStack with a list of row views, and this is a custom view that I have created. I'll just jump into it in just a moment. And we have a button. Okay, our list contains dummy users, and the user in those dummy users is added to our row view. Okay, here is our dummy users, and let's take a look at the MVVM user first. Okay, this is my model, pretty simple. It needs to be identifiable, so we can add it to a list. If you don't know what this is, go ahead and take a look at my previous video about dynamic lists. So we have this ID as a UUID, and we have some parameters, our UID, and please notice that we do have this ID, and this is used in our list, but we also have this UID because, and this is an integer, because in a database, most objects, well, I believe all of the objects will have a unique identifier. And so this UID is in fact the ID on the database. And I have conformed it to decodable because this will be unwrapped from a JSON file. Okay, we have first name, last name, email, and avatar URL. Hooray, we are going to fetch images in this tutorial too. So let's go back here and let's take a look at our row view. And our row view is basically having a user, an MVVM user, and a remote image URL. Now, I won't go into very much detail on how you have to or you can fetch images from a server with the help of a URL, of course. But go ahead and take a look at the link in the description and find out in the code. And for that, we have this remote image URL.swift file that we are using, and basically we are creating an observable object for the remote URL, and we are fetching basically the image URL's data and storing it in this published data variable. Once we do have, or once this observable object, let me just go back here into row view. We have created our observed object as a remote image URL. So once this observed object changes its value, all of this view is basically redrawn, and it is checking if the image URL data is empty. If it is, then we are going to use our empty placeholder. Well, this is basically an asset that I have added here. If not, then we are just going to use the remote image URL's data, and we are going to cast that into a UI image. And because we are in Swift UI, that UI image is cast into an image. I know this is a whole mouthful, but yeah, that is in short how you can grab remote image is with a remote image URL. And basically that's it. We have talked about our content view and our model. Now it's time for the good stuff. We are going to create a user's view model. But before we do that, let me just go ahead and run this app and see that these two dummy users are in fact going to be populated inside our list. But of course, we want to have something fetched from the internet. And for that, I am just going to go into the user's view model. And before we just dive into how to create this user's view model, let's just go and create our JSON files and some API. And you can do this for free on Mockaroo, if I pronounced that correctly, on mockaroo.com. So hit command and click on this. Sign up if you haven't already done so. It's free. It has a really good tier. And now we are going to build out a schema, and for that, an API. Please go ahead, stay with me. We are going to get to the MVVM part real soon. So we are going to need, this is a new schema, so we are going to do a UID, and that is a row number, that is an integer. We are going to, let me just go back here to our MVVM user model. We are going to use our first name. So let's paste that in there. A last name. There we go. Email is okay. I don't need gender and IP address at this moment. We are going to add another field, and that field will be an avatar. Okay, and let's just paste avatar URL there. Okay, I'm just going to fetch only 10 rows because that's okay. Make sure that the format is set to JSON and select array and include null values too. And let's just preview this, okay? This is what we are going to fetch when we do fetch this. But for that, first of all, let's save this schema. Okay, and I'm just going to call this users. Okay, let's save it. And now we have to create a get API basically. And let's create a new mock API here. And users JSON, users generate 10, that is okay. So what we are doing is using the user schema, we are just basically generating 10 users, and we can access this in our browser with this URL, okay? Let's see, no API method was found. Oh, maybe we need to save this. Oh, let's create our API. Make sure that we hit that, and let's just try again. There we go. Here we have our JSON file. And I'm just going to copy this API URL back into my user's view model under API URL. We are just going to use that. So that's that. Mockaroo, real nice. Now, let's talk about what we came here for is the view model part of our MVVM part. So we have created, I just go through line by line because it's kind of tedious to type this out and we are really short on time. So we are just going to create a simple observable object with a published variable of users array. Now this users is of course the MVVM user model object. And of course we have an array because yeah, we are fetching more than one users. And finally, we have this fetch users function that we are going to use on our button. Now, if you don't know what observable object published is, go ahead and take a look at another of my previous episodes on state and binding and observable object and published on my YouTube channel. So yeah, that is going to cover everything about observable objects. Basically, what you need to know is when users is changed in any way, we are going to get notified and we are going to reload the list. Okay, now the list that I'm going to create in just a second. Let's go over our fetch users. First of all, I want to remove everything from the users array so we get that nice animation that everything is deleted and it is populated again. We got let unwrap our URL because, yeah, this is just a string and maybe I just typed it in here, rebeloper.com, which isn't a JSON file. Okay, or maybe it doesn't really exist. So if this URL exists, then we can start our data task in a URL session. And of course, make sure you resume that data task. I always forget this. Make sure you resume it. It will not start then, basically. I'm checking for errors and printing it out if there are any with this session, and I'm returning. If there are any errors, I don't want to continue. Again, I guard let unwrap the response as an HTTP URL response. If this doesn't unwrap correctly, then I return again. If the status code is 200, then everything is A-OK. Then I can move forward. Otherwise, I'm just going to print out the response code and maybe get some information about how to solve this in debugging. Now I have to take care of the data. The data is also an optional, so I guard let unwrap that. And then I try to decode it with JSON decoder, decode. It's simple. This is an API provided by Swift. Okay, and then I add that into our users. And again, please note that the users is a published variable. So whenever it changes, it will basically reload the list. Okay, we do try catch. If there is an error, we print out the error. So that is how you fetch the data from this API URL. Now, basically that is it for our view model. We have our published variable and we have a function that fetches users from a database. Now let's go back on our content view and wrap all of this up. As you can see here in the VStack, first of all, we have a list. Let's comment that out and create a new list with having that view model in mind. Now, first of all, if we want to use our view model, we have to create it. So let's see here. I am going under the at state private var animation state. Let's just create at observed object, and this needs to be an observed object because the class that I'm going to use is an observable object again. So var users view model equals users view model. Okay, so now we have our users view model and all of its properties. Now we can go down and create our list. So we are going to create a simple list, and I'm going to insert as the elements the view models. There we go. Users view model dot users. And as you can see, we already have auto completion, and we are going to use user in. And the rest is kind of the same because we are just going to create a row view with a height of 250. Okay, and basically that is it. Now, if we build and run, we won't see anything because at the moment, the users array is empty. So what we need to do is just add some functionality to our button, and under the fetching, it's pretty simple. We are inside the closure now, so let's start with self. and users view model, and let's just call it the fetch users. And yes, this is everything you have to know. And again, please note, let me just delete this, how simple it is and how structured it is. We are going to be concerned in the view only about the views. And we are going to be concerned only about data manipulation, fetching, and so on inside the view model only. So let's build and run and see this in action. There we go, it's loading. And of course, because it's an empty array at first, we don't see anything. So let's tap on fetch here, and it is going to fetch. As you can see, first of all, we do get the placeholder image, and then we are downloading the images from the URLs that you can see here. So the first one is robohash.org and so on, and we are getting a PNG back basically. So let me just go back here and let's just scroll a little bit. Okay, and as you can see, it's really smart. It doesn't really fetch the unshown images on the that are not shown on the screen just yet. No. There we go. That is it for MVVM. Now you know how to use MVVM in SwiftUI. I want you to hit that notification bell because in my next video, I'm going to actually talk about SF symbols in SwiftUI. If you're interested, make sure you hit the notification bell so you don't miss that video. In the meantime, while you wait for that one, make sure you also check out these two videos that I have over here. I talk a lot about iOS development, SwiftUI, and how to code smarter. So make sure to check out these videos as well. And as always, I will see you in the next one.